Record button. Starting the game. Wah, where am I? What is up, everyone? It is Lovenji Gaming, and we are here with game number 4 of this 7-game showmatch between the two of them. Between the two of them. I say the two of them like you know who it is, although if you've been watching the games previous, you do know who this is. Starting as the yellow try in the blue base. He's up 3 games so far. He has won on Face Me, Yggdrasil, and Multitasking. Representing Clan Divinity's Slaves, it is Nici. Spawning in the red position as the red tribe. Down 3 games. I feel like he almost had the Multitasking game, but not quite. Representing Clan Overpowered, it is Babo. So this map is called 69, and it does have the spectator script enabled because I was smart and did it for this map. The interesting thing I like about this map is you have a safe base and a vulnerable base, because what you have to do is you have to build out your base in quite a long fashion. And so where your vulnerable base is, you're close to the opponent's main base, and vice versa. This stone head here is for 40 followers and will give you a single charge of the warrior training hut. So at the moment, both of our tribes have no access to the warrior hut. There's only a fire warrior hut. This map was made by Arbrin, of course. Was this the one that was made by Arbrin? I don't remember. It's a warrior hut. Sorry, my chat was asking what the stonehead gives. So, as you can see, players have to be quick. They have to convert both sides of their base, and they're going to be getting a defense up on the weak side. Which you can see is happening here. Fire Warrior Training Hut is going up for Babo. Nisi's actually opting to wait a little longer on his Fire Warrior Training Hut. I don't actually see a plan for it at all yet. This might be it here. This looks pretty wide. Nope, that's also a hut. Never mind. Making it up. Maybe this is the Fire Warrior Hut. I'm just going to keep saying maybe this is the Fire Warrior Hut until one of them is eventually the Fire Warrior Hut. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, this is the fire warrior hut. You little menace. Yeah, so fire warrior training hut now going up board Nici as well. Babo opting to patrol his safe base. Nici actually doing the same, although not patrolling. He's sat in a tower. I actually like this from Nici, the tower here, because that's going to be able to reach all of this with an earthquake. And they are both charging an earthquake, although Babo actually went for a land bridge first. He's got a land bridge in the chamber. And isn't that far behind Nisi's earthquakes. And I think Nisi spent a little bit longer converting. There's the land bridge from Babo. The Fire Warrior training hut has only just been finished. Only one Fire Warrior has been produced. Babo's on his way with an earthquake. Just about ready to cast. Here it goes. There it is. There's the earthquake. Is it going to be on the Fire Warrior training hut? The blast from Babo doesn't quite kill Nici. Earthquake does go down. Nisi's shaman does die. Good earthquake, although the Fire Warrior training hut is still in one piece. You might want to deal with that. Blast onto the Fire Warrior does take him out. So Nici only has one Fire Warrior available to him at the moment. Ice-T, who is a veteran in the Populous The Beginning community, is saying that is bad placement of the earthquake. And I'm inclined to agree. It didn't do as much damage as you would have liked. I suppose the wishful thinking was that it cut this way and then it would take out a hut and a Fire Warrior training hut. But you play with the RNG gods and that is what happens. Babo is actually building on Nisi's side of the base. He's taken advantage of the fact that Nici was a little bit slow to build. He's taken the trees. He's building guard towers. He's really hitting Nisi's ability here. Nici is already working on a second Fire Warrior training hut. I like this from him. He needs Fire Warriors to alleviate this pressure. there aren't going to be any warriors coming. So, because neither player has prayed to their stonehead, because you need 40 population to do so. You see throwing out a cheeky convert there. He's a wild man's like, yeah, you can join my tribe. It's looking so good for us right now. Here comes some fire warriors to pressure Nisi Shaman. Population's 45 for Babo, the red tribe, and 37, 38 for Nisi, the yellow tribe. Nisi's charged one Lambridge. He's working on a second. He's got an earthquake ready to strike back at Babo. Both Shamans trading a couple of blasts here. Babo building towers. He's building a defense in Nisi's base. Whoa, what a combination. I'm not sure that that was skill and wasn't just luck, but hey, good follow-up blasts there from Babo combined with the Fire Warrior shots. Get a kill onto Nisi, and we've got a big push from Fire Warriors coming in now. Now, Babo doesn't actually have an earthquake, so he's just pushing with troops right now. Big shots from those red Fire Warriors. Could be dealing all sorts of damage. No, they're just patrolling around the Shaman. Okay, never mind. Abba's been a little bit slow about placing his plans down and getting them built. I hope he doesn't put too much... emphasis on this pressure. We saw in the Yggdrasil game, Nisi can absorb pressure pretty well. These Fire Warriors in guard towers are going to be hard to deal with. There's even Braves coming forward to try and strip some of these down. Nisi's got 6 Fire Warriors to Babo's 3. We know where all 3 of Babo's Fire Warriors are. Nisi's are all hiding in huts. Earthquake is soon to be complete for Babo, so he can whittle away at Nisi once more with yet another earthquake, which we will expect to just get placed here or something. Oh no, Nisi's Shaman did just get caught by the blast from Babo there and does come down. Ice T in my chat says SWT a gameplay, and I say to you, Ice, this is an SW map. So there you go. It explains it all, doesn't it? This is SW Mute Worlds or Mute Battles? I don't remember. SW Mute Worlds, Mute Battles. In fact, I don't think this one was made by Arbrim. This one was made by The Dark Angle. That's who made this map. Arbrim made the other SW map that is in this pool. But here comes Nisi. Throws down a swarm to empty one of those towers. That was built a couple of huts there. Not expecting to keep them for too long, I suspect. Babo's got the 40 population, but he needs to see that this isn't praying. He's built too close to it. This isn't praying. He could lose 40 population here. Nisi's sending all of his population into Babo's base. Babo quickly separates his Braves back out. Very important that he did that. Earthquake from Nisi into the heart of Babo's base. Could be devastating. But it isn't. It's not that bad. Although it does get a lot of Fire Warriors there. Does burn down 2 huts. Good amount of population. The Shaman duel. Babo misses the final blast. That could be so critical right now because Nisi's going to hunt down his population. Look at all these Fire Warriors that Nisi has brought forward. This was Babo's game to lose, and I think Babo's just managed to lose it. A very strong push from Nisi. He smells blood and just goes for it. Yeah, the core camp is there. Goes the Shaman. Straight up into the air. Babo's sending Braves to try and deal with the Fire Warriors, which is clever. Ice is saying you should never run back to your base, and I'm inclined to agree. Let's take a little look at the populations. Babo's got 80 green bar, but only 30 actual pop. And Nisi's pop is now spread out amongst Babo's base. They're going to deal all sorts of damage, cause all sorts of chaos. Babo needs to free up this core camp. No, he quits. Doesn't even say GG. He doesn't surrender. He quits. That's game number four to Nici, and that really was Babo's game to lose. Really big mistake there. Unfortunate, but that is the way of Populous. Sometimes it gives, and sometimes it takes.